Hi, I'm Laura with the Canadian Museum of Nature. I'm here at the museum's new National Biodiversity Cryobank of Canada at our Natural Heritage Campus where our scientific collections and labs are located. This new facility is a game changer for biodiversity research in this country. And here to talk about it is Roger Bull, head of the Cryobank's operations and of our molecular biodiversity lab.
So right now we're in the Cryobank. And behind me are six ultra-cold freezers that maintain minus 170 degrees Celsius. And this is very, very cold, and it's cold enough to maintain the molecular structure of the DNA molecules in our samples for decades and decades to come. So the tissues in this collection are going to be really, really valuable. The cold temperature will preserve not only DNA, but other molecules in there, such as RNA, proteins, any toxins that are in the samples. And so there's many, many different research projects that will be supported by the tissue collection here. So in terms of DNA, we can use DNA analysis to study evolutionary relationships between species, to answer really basic questions like, what is a species? But also we can use the DNA to look at the health of populations and to identify if there's any populations that have low genetic diversity, for example, and might merit some conservation efforts. So these freezers incorporate really exciting new technology, and that's in the black boxes that you see on top of them there. That's a cryocooler that continuously recondenses the liquid nitrogen coolant inside the freezer. And the way that this works in particular is that there's two loudspeakers in there that create sound waves that condense helium gas. And when that helium gas expands again, it takes heat away from the nitrogen tank, recondensing the liquid nitrogen. So now that we're open, we're going to be inviting donations of tissues from research organizations such as universities and government research labs so that we collect here a huge collection of tissues that are really, really valuable for biodiversity research. And then we'll post the data online so that researchers around the world can see the tissue collections that we hold here so that they can request a sample for their own research. In this way, we'll be bringing together collections that are all across the country into one place here so that they're available to the world.